Thank you. The very first is a gentleman that is new to Chesterton Middle School, one of our world geography teachers. It's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Myers. And we were looking for a counterpart of equal air, and so we traveled to the science department, and it's my pleasure to bring out for our second narrator, Mrs. Hall. So they're going to read the poem. If you know the poem, then hopefully this is not new to you. But this is our interpretation of The Night Before Christmas. We need a little more ambiance if we could here. A little roasting fire there. Very nice.
Christmas went all through the house. Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wandering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick.
And he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the cursors they flew, with the sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too.
Thank you.
tracing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself.
His eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all his stockings, then turned with a jerk. And laying his fingers aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away all they flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight,
"Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Thank you.